Okay. Yeah, this goes. Why do I not hear anything? There we go. Peace Walker HD Edition. What extras are there? Oh, yeah, I did actually want to adjust this, didn't I? Okay, that's better. Okay, return to title menu. Hey, Catastrophe. And yeah, I guess Azir had to leave. Go to sleep before we started. I'm gonna go to about midnight. Maybe a little bit earlier. Yeah, it's really early for Sassy, so it's not too surprising when she had to go. I guess we're good to go because I did all the mother base stuff in advance last time. That's right. Tank battle.
Snake, that's an enemy tank unit. Either neutralize the soldiers or destroy the tank.
Okay, get so up. One or the other. I don't know. Seems good to me. It's really weird. They didn't do too much to upgrade the textures and stuff.
Neutralize that tank unit. You can do it. They're trying to find you. Make sure they don't.
It's fucking dudes.
Someone attack. The enemy's attacking.
Oh, fucking owned! Oh my god! They just got run over by the tank.
Someone attacking.
I like that this dude cannot see me.
The enemy's attacking! Going to alert status!
My suppressor is going to be dead soon enough. So I'm just gonna try and neutralize the soldiers. It seems like a good way to do this. Oh shit, coming back now. Oh yeah, I should Fulton these dudes. Oh shit!
Enemy's close by! Enemy sighted! Engaging now!
Oh shit! Up, up, up and away! Shit!
Enemies close by!
Oh wait! Oh shit! That's not a good thing. Oh man, that's really bad. Oh my god. Oh, lots of buffering, Rex? Oh, fuck off with your tanks and shit. Fuck, dude. Oh my god, I need to get somewhere else. This is a really bad spot to be in. Oh wait, but I bet I can shoot those. Yeah. Hit the gas tanks for massive damage. Oh fuck! Oh no. Hey, Vincent. Oh, fuck off! Okay, dude, you need to move. Receive ammo and items. Oh shit, I'm out of ammo for that. Oh shit! Oh fuck, right at me! Come on, I want my goodies. I assume you guys can hear me, right? Ah, okay, there we go. For a fucking cardboard. Oh, I see, a cardboard box is in. Rations, nice, and some ammo. Okay, so shooting the back of the tank is... Okay, there we go. So I just need to take out the captain now, which might be more efficient to do with. He's one box punch! Are you guys able to hear me, or...? Okay, Because it kind of seems like he can't hear me.
The enemy leader's out.
Can you hear me? Holding that sucker. Puppy. Grenade rank. Okay, well, I guess I'm gonna go and check that you can actually hear me once we're back to the mother base menu.
Snake, the truck is headed up the mountain road past the tunnel.
So it was nukes after all.
I guess I can just do this.
Their main base is up ahead.
I better hurry after them then.
But
Kaz, if I don't get moving, it'll be too late.
All right. I guess you never did let dangerous assignments or risk aversion get in your way.
How do I get inside the mountain? I can forget about the tunnel.
Yeah, the tank took care of that.
Any other routes?
Why don't I let a local expert take over?
Snake, you need a way into the mountain?
Yeah, got one.
Let's see. Do you remember that precinct I was in?
In the village, right?
Right. Go back to the village and head north. There is a bridge that connects to the mountain road. It crosses over a gorge. That's probably the best way. But there is a little problem. The path heading north from the village is barricaded. You might have to break through.
Got it.
The heart of Irasu. That's where the enemy's base has got to be, Snake. And maybe...
Let me guess.
Basilisco.
Basilisco.
You don't believe me, do you?
No, I mean, we'll have to see.
Snake, Irasu features a number of crater lakes. The Odeberg government had planned to use those lakes to construct hydroelectric plants as one of its big state development projects. The project was scrapped, but there's still a small opening at the bottom of the lake.
Meaning?
I checked the satellite imagery, but didn't see anything man-made, which means they probably built a base inside the mountain. Could just be a storage igloo for explosives, or maybe some kind of research facility.
What do they hope to accomplish by bringing the nukes there?
First things first, get past that barricade north of the village. Looks like the only way through is the noisy way. You'll have to blow it up.
Kaboom! Alright, back to Mother Base. You can have trade, okay, with other players, whatever. Yeah, whatever. Machine guns, M60. Sonic Eye, sensor that displays nearby sound sources as animated symbols. Only work when lying down or against a wall. Nagant, spicy curry, alligator went leveled up. Bluegill, pronghorn, yellowtail, koipu, boa. Sent to the brig due to intense hostility. Brig. Hippopotamus. Oops. So why is... Oh, okay, it is dropping. Thank you. Okay, yeah, so pretty much anyone who is semi-competent at medical abilities is on the medical team. That guy's better at that, yeah. Okay, well, I guess that's as good as it gets then. Database, trade, R&D, weapons. Yeah, let's develop this. Yeah, let's develop some spicy curry recipes. Is Twitch still fucked up? Like,
let me just have a look here. I know Twitch was fucked up earlier, but... I'm wondering if chat is... Okay, online. Yeah, it all seems good right now.
Yeah, I don't know. Kind of weird. I don't know why I'd be buffering. Destroy the barricade. Destroy it with C4, which I guess means I need to bring C4.
Snake, I've got just the explosive to bust through that barricade. C4. We finished developing C4 charges. Take some with you.
That's really weird. Like, Twitch status is showing everything as okay. Some of the Twitch, some of the chat servers are a little slow, but...
Go back to the prison camp. It's in the village where they were holding Chico.
You're doing great, Snake! Peace!
Make your way back to... Use C4. We're counting on...
Are you familiar with Leafcutter Ant, Snake? They help mushrooms grow. We have them in Costa Rica. The mushrooms provide the ants with spores to eat, and in exchange, the ants protect them from predators.
Kinda like us, huh?
That is not why I brought it up.
So where are we trying to go? We're trying to go there. So yeah, we gotta go back through the coffee factory. Nothing. Analyze this dude. He's not bad. You got a weather balloon.
Fulton recovery subject confirmed onboard helicopter.
Oh, hey, dude. Wall. Oops. I didn't mean to just snag him. Hey, Vlasno. Where am I going?
Fulton recovery helicopter is complete.
Eat wall or floor.
Huh. Hamilton recovery subject.
So I'm actually really enjoying this game. It's actually a lot of fun. And I can imagine, like, Jesus, if this was on handheld, it'd be amazing.
You could probably climb that if you had someone to lend you a hand.
I imagine a lot of the improvements are just from the controls, though. Oops. Come on. Not to mention it has co-op, which would be pretty goddamn awesome. And just using the PS3 controller rather than the PSP itself is a lot better. Yeah, we just got that guy into pooping position. Alright, let's see if this guy's worth the trouble. I've already played MGS4, Adam. I played it maybe 2 months ago now? Yeah, I did 1, 2, 3, 4, then I did Portable Ops, and I'm doing Peace Walker. So after this I'll be doing Ground Zeroes. This isn't the right menu. This isn't what I wanted at all. So I've already played 4. Next up will be Ground Zeroes, and then we'll probably loop around and do Metal Gear 1. Oh shit.
Enemies close by.
Metal Gear 1 and 2. And and then we'll get into the wacky stuff, like we'll do Ghost Babel, and we will do Snake's Revenge, and the Metal Gear Acid games. Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to play through all the whole series, everything, so at this point, I'm not playing it again right now.
It was from there, and it'll take you straight to the prison camp.
Head west, so I guess this way? I'm assuming that's west. Yeah, that's west.
On the northwest side of the prison camp.
Okay, I see why I couldn't
cross the camp to get there.
Figure out how to get through this door before. Oh, you stopped letting them up, Snake Eater? So wait, where am I going? I'm going north from here? Yeah. Who the fuck is it?
Somebody there.
Oh. Is that one, I think, that heard me? Where the fuck is that? Ah, that's it over there.
I know I saw something.
Yeah, I think Twitch is still having issues, even though they say everything is fixed right now.
Enemy attack.
What the fuck is going on? Where the fuck to sleep? Fuck. God damn it.
Alert.
Oops. Ah, fuck. I done goofed. You dick, buddy. Oh, yeah, the stream with Ryan was good today. And then Felicia came on the end and started trolling him via Skype.
Bolton recovery to helicopter is complete. The barricade is located somewhere in that vicinity.
I'm assuming this is the barricade in question.
Once the charge is planted, press the attack button without the speed work thing. Excellent. Now, make your way north.
Destroy barricade. Mission complete. The missions are so weirdly chopped up, but... like, why is that a mission on its own? But I guess it's just to make it more convenient on a portable format. Yeah, I mean, it would kind of stop you, just a little concrete barricade, but yeah, I mean, you could have jumped over that in reality.
Snake, you there?
Yeah, what's up?
You've got to talk to Amanda.
What happened?
She wants to leave sickbay and get back on the battlefield, but she's not fully healed. She's still in crutches. Who'd be crazy enough to try and fight like that? You have to talk some sense into her.
Is she with you right now?
No, she's in sickbay. She keeps shouting about how she doesn't want to be there. She won't shut up about it. She's driving me-
Let her go.
What?
If that's what she wants, let her go.
I'm really not in the mood for jokes, Snake.
I'm serious.
Let her go.
Let her go.
Let her go.
So she can come back in a body bag?
I'm really not in the mood for jokes, Kaz.
What are you talking about?
Amanda isn't the type to just sit around in sickbay. She has a sense of duty. Her purpose in life is to fight. The battlefield isn't just the best thing for her. It's the best thing for her compass, too. She'll be a huge morale boost that can only benefit MSF.
You think so?
You're good at fighting, Kaz. One of the best. But you've got a lot to learn when it comes to people.
So, where should I put her?
I'll think it over and find a team for her. Don't worry. She won't let us down.
Whatever you say, boss.
Alright, we got our Trank sniper rifle. Got our spicy curry. And dudes are leveling up. I am assuming by how many more of these do you have left, you mean Metal Gear Solid, or like Metal Gear games? If that's what you mean, then we've got Ground Zeroes after this, and we've got Metal Gear 1 and 2, we've got Snake's Revenge, we've got Ghost Babel, we've got Metal Gear Acid 1 and 2. I think that's it. I think there's 7 more Metal Gear series games left. And then Phantom Pain will be coming out in September. Of course, that's 7, one of which is Ground Zeroes, which is like a one stream thing. That won't be long. Staff. No, I wanted to do staff. Hey, this dude. Oh, this dude's no good at food. Because civets are the, other things, the cats that they feed the coffee beans, and then they brew the pooed out coffee beans. So I would have expected him to be good in the cafeteria. I wonder when I can actually use these vehicles. I should put a list of all the remaining games down under my video, and then I can... Because otherwise I'm going to forget about things like Ghost Babel and stuff.
Of the village. The truck carrying the nukes is heading towards the heart of the mountain. That's its final destination. We've got no intel on what lies beyond.
Hey, welcome back, Fantastic. Alright, I guess we are good to go. So, cross the bridge.
You could probably climb that if you had someone to lend you a hand.
So basically, if you had multiple people, this would be a lot easier. Analyze this dude. He's okay. Then we analyze this dude. He's okay too.
Fulton recovery helicopter is complete.
Analyze this dude. Oh shit, he's good. Duck rock, duck rock.
Recovery subject confirmed onboard helicopter.
The bunny walk isn't quite as... He's not quite as much of a bunny walk as he did before. The fuck? What was that noise? It sounded like... I don't even know. Only one dude there? Oh, whatever, we'll just sneak past him. Actually, I could probably just clobber him and... Just wait until that dude turns around and... We'll slam him into a wall. Oh, wait, why don't I... Taste this, bro. Of course you tied a balloon to him and sent him up to a helicopter. What else would you do with these dudes after you give them a little spanking? Oh shit. Nothing.
What was that?
You sure are. No. Who would see that? I mean, it's just a normal occurrence when you send your dudes up in their balloons. Oh shit, I missed! Don't tase me, bro! Oh, come on, analyze him. Oh fuck, gotta go right for the butt if you wanna analyze him. He's good too! Send him into the wonderful world of the sky. Whee! Shit, that guy, dude's got a rocket launcher. Man, why haven't I been using the stun rod? Why have I been... Oh, shit.
Enemies close by.
They've got rocket launchers.
Fuck off, dude. Where the fuck to sleep? There we go. That guy's garbage, though. Give him a little spanking.
Freeze.
So when you hold them up like that, they stay like that until, either you enter alert mode, I think, or if a buddy comes across them. To be honest, would you notice if a man was flying up in a balloon into the sky? I doubt it. Especially at that kind of speed.
The base is beyond that fort. You've got to get past it somehow.
Don't tase me, bro! Right in the deck. I tased that dude right in the deck. Euro Truck is good anytime, Catastrophe.
And recovery helicopter is complete.
What?
Wait.
Oh, those dudes. Oh, whatever.
Can't be imagining things. Wait.
Oops.
What's going on?
Oh shit, I suppose I can't really do that, can I? Because I I can't actually get them.
We're under attack. Going to alert status.
Understood.
Oh, that's not a good thing.
Proceed with extra caution.
Something there. The enemy's here.
Suck a dick.
Understood. Eliminate all hostiles.
Shit. Oh, fuck off. That's not the right one. I want these ones. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. That's also not what I wanted. Why are shotties so fun? Why is my video gone? There we go. Now my video's back. Oh, fuck off with your grenades. Who said you could use them? Oh, fuck. How did I get fucked over like this? God damn it. I feel safe. Love pack. All right, let's fault me, Steve. Oops.
This is patrol. Target lost. Going to alert status.
Understood. The enemy should still be nearby. Find him.
Alright, that's all. My Fulton's gone.
Fulton recovery subject confirmed onboard helicopter.
Alright, we are good.
HQ, come in.
This is HQ.
This is patrol. All clear.
Understood. Stay vigilant.
Where are these dudes? Horses. Horsies.
Guys, I'm inside the facility. There's rows and rows of trucks here.
If that's where they brought the nukes, then the truck we're after should be there. Snake, can you tell which one of the trucks brought the nukes? One of them must have the same license plate as
140.96. That's... Shinagawa? Fuck, I don't know. Jesus. I assume it's the different one.
Not this one.
Hey, I just have a mirror. Maybe it was that one? Oh, it's
Mr. Kojima.
Alright. Well, I just... It's the 63 one? I'm gonna go with... Fuck, none of them are 63 ones. 64?
This is the one. The exhaust's still warm. The cargo's already been offloaded.
Just a minute. This isn't what we agreed on. It's too late. The changes have already been finalized. You told me it was going to be a deterrent, that we wouldn't have to launch.
I am not arguing with you, Doctor. Our goal is to create the perfect deterrent.
That's why I agreed to help develop it.
However, in order to achieve the perfect deterrent...
You haven't missed too much. I fought a tank.
Three key principles ensure effective nuclear deterrence. First, you must have nuclear weapons. Second, you must never use them first.
Thank you for following Lambda Prime, by the way.
And third, and most important, if someone attacks you, you must strike back. Unless we prove beyond a doubt that these three principles work in practice, the world will not accept our new deterrent. And the only way to do that is to show them we are capable of actually launching a nuke.
Isn't deterrence supposed to stop nukes from being used?
Exactly. And so the one we launch will be the last one ever.
I won't let you use my creation like that.
Your creation? That thing wasn't even your idea to begin with. You stole it, didn't you?
Stole it! You're one to talk! You got the idea for bipedal locomotion from the communists in the first place!
You listen to me, Doc. Keep quiet. Do as I say. Not another word about stolen ideas. Should we succeed here, you'll be the toast of the...
1960s Batman game would be amazing.
And your name will go down in history as champion of both progress and national security.
The hell with that!
Doctor! Unless we prove we are capable of launching, Peacewalker is useless as a deterrent. You used me! We used each other. I'll get my old director's job back at headquarters.
And running around like this with the bomb over your head? Walk tall. And you can pull out your, what was it, the anti-shark shield?
How unfortunate. Guess I'll just have to take your legs for myself. Peace won't just come to us, Doc.
Well, there's the shark repellent bat spray, but then he has the bat shield or whatever that, like... comes out, it's like plexiglass, and folds down from four parts. What the fuck does that say? Goldman?
Wait!
Hey, you okay?
Don't do it!
Snap out of it. Where are the nukes?
He's gonna do it! He's gonna launch a nuke!
It can't be that complicated, right? Just have a mirror? Whoosh. Peacewalker. So here is the titular Peacewalker. thing is sweet. Koopa, amphibious AI attack craft. Unmanned gear. To be continued in the next mission. A couple of Ewoks in a log. Ewoks in a log can take out pretty much everything. Just give me a second here. I just got an email from someone. Tomorrow evening. Yeah. Okay, I'll respond to that later. I don't know, Deceptive Mirror. We'll have to find out, and I imagine we'll find out at the end of the next mission. I've been awarded a new codename! I'm a beautiful butterfly! Title given to soldiers who mainly use short-range weapons and favor taking down enemies with non-lethal force. I awarded a new insignia, Headshot Master, rank C. You transpose letters in S-U-L-T? I'm calling myself Slut? Hey, Weeping Termite. I'm not sure where you saw S-U-L-T. Oh, I see. It says it. Oh, okay. That's because I don't see that. Yeah, that says, like, mission result or something. I was like, what the fuck are you talking about, S-U-L-T? But yeah, it is right there next to my picture, isn't it? Hideo joined! Yeah, so I found Hideo Kojima in one of that, in one of the trucks. Magpie. Koipu, Moonrass. New plant is being built thanks to staff efforts. This dude's a dick. Oh, nice. Today was a badass in medical skills. Hideo Kojima is the guy who created Metal Gear Solid, or Metal Gear. And, yeah, he was working on the new Silent Hill game, and, yeah. Basically, he shut that down. Because he didn't... Because there was some falling out between him and Konami, and so... He didn't let them use Fox Engine for the new Silent Hill game, and then basically that canceled the project. What am I looking at? R&D, I guess. What do we got? We got submachine gun, might as well develop it, and the solid magazine. New level 2 analyzer. All right, let's fight this fucker. Pupa battle. Stop the enemy's pupa weapon in its tracks.
Careful, Snake. I've never seen anything like that, and I've got no idea how to bring it down. Maybe the scientist knows. However you do it, take that thing out.
Single player. We probably don't need the Mark 22 for this mission. I would imagine the law would be very useful. That's probably good, I guess. Hey, Blue Bomber. I'm really enjoying this game. This is a, I mean, infinitely better than Portable Ops, and I'm ranking it up there. It's pretty good so far. Very confusing that the game does not pause when.
An AI weapon, the pupa. It's fast, so be careful.
Oh, fuck
off! Aim for the cylindrical AI pod.
Yeah, okay, that's I already figured that out. Dumb shit. Fuck off with your singing. Yeah, MGS great games are great with MSG. So if I recall correctly, the singing is actually that Vocaloid thing. They actually licensed Vocaloid for this game. Or I guess maybe not licensed because it's a Sony game.
Take what? Those lightning rods out. They direct its electroshock attack.
Lightning rod? Wait, this gotta be a safe edge spot, right? Where the fuck is he going?
There'll be some warning signs when it's coming out!
Ramping that fucker. Yeah, pupa are usually pretty stationary, aren't they? Oh, fuck off, don't run me over. Don't run me over twice. Okay, so we need some fucking ammo.
They've okayed the request for support. They're sending out a cardboard box as we speak.
Alright, we got some ammo and some rations. We want this fucker. Commencing jump. Oh, god damn it, I missed. Codename Sidewalk. I think it's coming out of that one. Just based on the singing. Yep. Da-da-da! Da-da-da! From now on, I'm just gonna announce my arrival with singing. Da-da-da! Da-da-da! Da-da-da-da-da! Fuck off! Oh, fuck off! Seriously! The fuck up! Oh, fuck! I missed! Motherfucker! Oh shit! Oh my god, I'm so fucking close to dying. I love your face! Libation of... Metal Gear Solid 2 has the man on roller skates.
The black memory boards are locked. Go after the board.
What?
The icons.
What the fuck am I doing? I don't understand.
You can unlock memory boards by destroying the mechanical.
I don't understand what I'm doing.
Any boards you remove can
oh, I see.
Build our own AI okay. weapon. Memory boards have different functions according to the icons displayed over them. Go ahead.
I get it.
What you want.
I will show you my blanket in a minute. Okay, I'm assuming just when time runs out, I'm done? Okay, yeah. Keep a battle, mission complete. So I just pillaged that sucker.
That was an unmanned weapon. A prototype. I made it myself.
Who are you?
I work here. Well, used to, anyway. Name's Huey.
Sweet chair climbing, or stair climbing wheelchair.
And who might you be? You don't look like one of those mercenaries.
Me? I'm an entomologist.
A fighting entomologist?
Yeah, I specialize in butterflies. I'm here to catch Ulysses.
Ulysses? Huh. I didn't think they lived in Costa Rica. Morphos, maybe?
That's it. Need to get some before the Washington Treaty goes into effect.
Says here Morphos aren't covered under the treaty.
Must have slipped my mind.
You sure you're feeling all right?
Anyway, long story short, the butterfly got away. So how about it, Doc? Did you make that big butterfly too?
He's an entomologist. Yes. Yeah, right, right.
And no.
What was that thing? What are they doing here?
Huh. Something tells me you're no ordinary entomologist. The nukes were loaded on that machine. The project's entering its final phase.
Project?
That's right. The thermonuclear warheads they brought in, the bases scattered throughout Costa Rica, the mercenaries, the AI weapons, the research we were conducting here. It's all for this. We used this facility to develop unmanned weapons.
Unmanned?
Robots. The one you just fought was a pupa. There's also a flying type called Chrysalis and a treaded type, the Cocoon. Motor control, target detection, tracking, attack, capture, and transport functions are all controlled by an electronic brain. There's no need for a human pilot. They can only
Let's zoom in past his close. Come on.
Why build them here?
For the CIA. They invited me here a year ago.
That's who that guy was.
CIA's station chief for Central America. Goes by the name of
Hot Coldman? What?
Apparently he was some sort of hero back at the height of the Cold War.
Hot Coldman.
He's the one running the show. We called it the Peacewalker Project.
Peacewalker.
They're going to deploy a new type of nuclear weapon along the Caribbean coast of Latin America. A mobile, unmanned nuclear platform.
Unmanned nuclear platform?
A failed deadly system that can automatically move into position and launch a retaliatory nuclear strike. It can move on its own, and stealth shields it from radar and satellite detection, drastically reducing the risk of it being destroyed in a preemptive strike.
And this is the new deterrent?
Supposed to be. The problem is the locomotion
system. Peace, Christopher Walker, Texas Ranger.
There's no dry season in the Caribbean. It rains all year round. The terrain is full of tropical rainforest. A lot of the time you can't even build a proper road. So I went back to where it all started.
What's that?
Legs. Walking power. A mobile launcher carrying a thermonuclear warhead even more powerful than the Soviet RDS 220s. That's Peacewalker.
Chico's Basilisco.
We did the assembly and field testing here.
A walking nuke.
I sort of borrowed the original idea from behind the Iron Curtain.
The missing link between infantry and artillery.
Metal Gear.
Metal Gear.
Metal Gear.
I like that he just comes up with the name Metal Gear, like, out of nowhere. Oh, I guess the Metal Gear was mentioned before.
And to get it, he's planning a test, which will also serve as a demonstration for the folks back at Langley.
Wait, he's launching a nuke to prove that his perfect deterrent works?
In his words, to prove that if someone attacks us, we will strike back. Put simply, nuclear deterrence is the idea of using nukes to keep nukes in check. If one side launches nuclear weapons, the other is sure to launch theirs in retaliation, which makes launching an act of suicide. In the end, neither side can use its nukes. It's thanks to this doctrine that the world's two superpowers have avoided all-out confrontation. Nuclear deterrence has brought us peace. At the very least, it's prevented another world war from breaking out. But the theory of nuclear deterrence exists only on paper. In reality, there's no guarantee that either side would follow through with retaliation. There's the chance that a preemptive strike could destroy all the missile bases, render them unable to retaliate. But the biggest flaw in the theory is that the decision to retaliate has to be made by human beings. Let me give you a real-world example. Let's say Country X launches first against Country Y. If the people in charge of Country Y are like you and me, they're not going to be able to retaliate, knowing that they're effectively ending all human life.
So then the weak link in nuclear deterrence theory is the uncertainty of retaliation.
Bingo. And that creates a loophole Country X can exploit to launch the first strike. Which is why we designed the system to be unmanned. With Peace Walker, retaliation is certain. It chooses the appropriate target and launches a retaliatory nuclear strike every time, without needing...
I like the little butterflies.
Launching a nuclear strike against Peace Walker is tantamount to pushing the launch button against yourself. It closes the loophole in nuclear deterrence theory, rendering our friends in Country X completely unable to launch. What Coldman is saying is that to achieve this goal, we need to demonstrate that retaliation will be carried out by a machine. He will launch his nuke. And then his version of deterrence will be complete.
And you believe him?
I believe in peace through nuclear deterrence.
Why?
My father worked on the Manhattan Project. He put his whole life into that research. And all it created was this illusion of peace called deterrence. And then I was born, unable to walk. I had no choice but to face up to the nukes. But if they do end up launching, it'll all have been for nothing. They've got to be stopped.
Good job, just having Mayor.
Where'd they take the warheads?
To a base near the border.
And yes, yeah, that was the point where it was confirmed.
Where's the base?
You're gonna stop them? It's kind of a hike. And besides, there's a surefire way to halt the project. You see, Peace Walker isn't quite finished yet.
What do you mean?
It's missing one last critical structural component. The AI. Its brain. The reptile pod, the electronic brain I was working on, can only follow commands like, go there, attack that. I guess you could compare it to the human cerebellum. But for nuclear deterrence to work, it must function in place of a human decision maker. It needs something to analyze the huge volumes of data coming in and select an appropriate target for retaliation. Hence, it needs the high-level decision-making ability of a cerebrum.
The mechanical cerebrum.
The hardware configuration is modeled on the human brain, similar to the pod I worked on.
Brains.
Where's it being made?
A research lab to the north. An AI expert named Dr. Strangelove is developing it. Very hush-hush.
Dr. Strangelove?
Strangelove was recruited from the States, too. In the field of AI, there's no one better, that's for sure. But man, what a basket case. She hates everybody. Go to the lab and destroy Peace Walker's cerebrum. I'm pretty sure they haven't finished the final calibrations yet. I'll lend you my ID card. It'll get you through security at the lab. Oh, and one more thing.
What's this? A letter of recommendation?
Yeah, it's from me to Dr. Strangelove. Don't read it, okay?
So what will you do now?
I'm done with science. At this rate, I'm probably already halfway to hell anyway.
What's with everyone sending me emails?
Not so fast. Why not join us? Our place is Outer Heaven. We'd fit right in.
Man, everyone wants to buy shit from me now.
I'm probably better suited to something like that than this paradise.
Good. You get a free balloon trip for signing up. Enjoy it. You'll feel like a butterfly.
You're an agent, right? Who do you work for?
Me. I was a Cold War tool, same as you. Now I'm not so useful anymore, so they cut me loose. I don't answer to anyone. Call me Snake.
Snake. That name seems familiar somehow.
Death's probably just deja vu.
See that there? Beyond the cloud forest? See those ruins?
Yeah.
That's where you'll find Dr. Strangelove's lab.
Yeah. Mission complete. Something without an army. What? The following words can now be infused with heroic spirit. Taking it slow. The following words can now be infused with heroic spirit. Here I am! Pertaining to design specs for the following weapon slash item supports blah 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 blah. Chaff grenade, night vision goggles.
Snake, the doctor's safe here with us.
Huey, how are you feeling?
Never better. This is quite the pad you've got here, boss. I'm impressed.
Call me Snake.
Whatever you say. Like it or not, everyone here calls you boss. By the way, if you're at all interested in improving your tech, by all means, assign me to the R&D section. I'm pretty sure I'll be of some use. Once we have the necessary materials and blueprints, we can start work on that bipedal mech.
I appreciate that, but are you sure you're okay with having your work used for war?
Yeah, my scores are dropping, Blue Bomber.
I'll be using it to keep past mistakes in check. If I can help thwart the Peace Walker project, I'm happy to do it.
Deterrence theory, Huey style, huh?
Anyway, if you need any intel on the enemy's weapons or electronic brains, contact me. I've been given my own frequency.
Sounds good to me, Doc. I'll do that.
Good. Whatever the means, you must put a stop to their plans.
Saving. Do not turn off the power.
Hey, boss.
Powwow.
Can we powwow for a sec?
What now? MSF brand rations?
Actually, that sounds... No. With all the men we have now, it may be time we started sending some of them to other countries.
You mean dispatching marks?
How else are we going to keep feeding the crew we have?
I know. You're right.
I haven't had any issues with that so far.
Select Outer Ops from the Mother Base menu. If it goes really well, we might even get new recruits, weapon design specs, or leads on new missions. We can deploy any vehicles or large-scale weapons in our arsenal as well.
And if things don't go really well?
Yeah, we could lose men. I won't try and force you. You're the one calling the shots here, boss.
Once I've done the mother base stuff, I'm just gonna get a... fill up my little water bottle thing with water and I will come back. Outer Ops, you can now deploy mercenary blah blah blah, okay. Huey joined. Huey! We got a new analyzer. ID card H, rank 1. Enables access to Strangelove's lab. Chaff grenade, night vision, magpie, the seahorse. This guy got hurt. Oh, they actually got sick. Hey, this is an outer heaven. Clipspringer. Okay, I assume he will auto-assign to the... Oh, oops, shit. I'm now in the negatives. Okay, let's see what the outer ops are. Yes, let's do the tutorial. Near a place with good food, any recommended Quiznos or a Domino's? Outer Ops, you can send units to conflict zones to participate in combat. Battles will take place as you progress time by completing main ops or extra ops. If your soldiers are victorious, they will gain experience and you will bring in greater amount of GMP. You can also obtain rewards and new recruits from the areas you help. However, if you are defeated, soldiers may come back injured or not come back at all. Mechs that sustain damage in battle can be repaired by temporarily removing them from the combat lineup. This concludes the tutorial. Alright, let's dispatch someone. I assume if I just send like a shit ton of dudes here, we'll just completely destroy them, right? I don't know. Let's do that. That's probably good enough for now. I guess we'll see how it goes. I'll probably like lose everyone. All right. And assuming there's no cutscene here, no. That's not my headphones, that's my controller. Alright. Travel to the Cloud Forest. What is that? Oh, that must be how many people can participate at a time, I guess.
Is the heart of the enemy's project. To prevent its completion, you'll need to either shut down or destroy the artificial intelligence that functions as its brain. According to Huey, that AI is now undergoing final calibrations in Strangelove's lab. It's inside a tropical cloud forest. Slip in and terminate that AI before they ship it out.
Right, so we want to get rid of the law, we want that. Yes, that's a good point, Useless Rogue. Maybe she's not basic. Them some horse feet. The Phantom Hero. Treadmill desks. Those things seem wacky.
Snake, how's the mule treating you?
At this pace, I should be there by tomorrow morning.
You've got to hurry. The AI could be completed any time now.
It'd be nice to have a guide.
Already on it. I've enlisted Paz to help you. She knows the jungle pretty well.
Snake, I know you are an expert in survival, but you need to stay alert. You are in an ancient jungle so foggy, you can hardly see the trees. It is home to 2,500 species of plants, including 400 types of orchids. There are also 500 species of butterflies and over 400 species of wild birds. The bedrock is solid enough that Mayan ruins have miraculously survived centuries of earthquakes.
An AI lab in a Mayan ruin. Who'd have thought, hey, Huey?
My sentiments exactly. That doesn't mean security's any less tight, though. You still have the ID card I gave you, don't you?
Got it right here.
That'll get you through the gate, no problem. After that, you're on your own. As long as the AI remains unassembled, Coldman's plan's on ice.
What about security inside the lab?
Well, it shouldn't be a problem for you.
Oh, he's eating a fish.
Strangelove demanded that the security presence inside the lab be kept to a minimum.
It's not all good news, Snake. Coldman knows we're here. He's raised security in the area surrounding the lab. You'll be seeing a lot of that Chrysalis UAV, and a bunch of patrol choppers, too. There may be scouts in the jungle lying in ambush. As you approach the lab, be extra vigilant.
I'll be careful.
To the north. It won't be long before the AI is complete. Don't let that happen.
Careful. If there's enemy scouts around here, they'll be nearly impossible to see.
Why? Why would they be nearly impossible to see?
May not spot enemies.
Nothing here.
Hidden.
Let's analyze this dude. He's not bad. You're coming with me, mister.
Recovery subject confirmed onboard helicopter.
Hello there, buddy. Chase me, bro. Give a girl a spanking. Suppose I should have checked that dude out before I...
Fulton recovery to helicopter is complete.
No, Felicia would drink it. I think she would try it. She would probably drink it. And then it'd be like, what the fuck are you making me drink? She would probably drink it. Let's be honest, dear. Yeah, she thought wine in a sealed plastic cup was a good idea. Oh. Barely saw that dude. Jesus, they are hiding well.
Nothing here.
No, no one. Yeah, I mean, I think I basically said that. Just have a mirror.
Freeze.
Oh, fuck. So many hiding...
Nothing here.
Hiding dudes. These guys are garbage. And where is that other dude? I think he's down there. Snake? Oh, there he is. I see him now. Variation of, okay, interesting. That guy's not bad. We'll take him with me.
Fulton recovery subject confirmed.
Is this where I actually want to go? I guess that's as good as anywhere else. Butterfly. A high D? It's not a high D. A, whatever. I'll make up my own terms. can now be infused with heroic spirit. I'm going it alone. I assume these are, those are the messages you can, like, shout out when you're doing co-op or something.
Thanks for putting me on the R&D team, Snake. I'll cut to the chase. We've commenced development on our own bipedal weapon. The only thing is, we don't exactly have easy access to resources here.
Yeah. Unfortunately, we don't have the budget of a defense department behind us.
I understand. That's why I want to ask you something. If you fight any more AI weapons, could you try to gather as many of their parts as you can? That would really make things go a lot smoother.
Again, easier said than done.
If anyone could do it, you can, boss. You single-handedly took out the pupa.
True.
Look, if you're not interested, I can just work with what we have here. I'm not trying to force you to take unnecessary risks. You're the boss around here.
Alright.
Alright, so he wants me to snag bets from...
But I'll think about it.
From these other
Great.
Dudes.
Also, each AI weapon has a head part that serves as the core of its armament. Recovering a head part will allow you to use the weapon associated with that part. But those guys won't go down without a fight, so don't get too preoccupied with this stuff.
Don't worry. I'm not about to risk my life for a bunch of scrap.
Oh, that's a terrifying thought, Bummer.
Our new bipedal weapon needs a name.
Good point. We can't keep calling it our bipedal weapon.
I had a talk with Miller, and we came up with Metal Gear Zeke.
Metal Gear... Zeke?
Yep. As you know, Metal Gear was coined by Grunin.
And Zeke?
It's a name the U.S. military gave to Japanese aircraft that flew during World War II. Zeke was the Japanese Navy's best fighter plane. So are you okay with that, Snake?
Sure. Fine by me.
Miller was saying that an army without borders will need a deterrent against other countries. He's right. With Metal Gear, MSF can achieve true independence.
Here's hoping.
Okay. Back to Mother Base. Metal Gear? Bipedal tank is now ready for development from the Metal Gear menu. Ration rank 2. Ballistic shield. Oh, just a second. That's actually a real email I want to see. Blah blah blah. You fucked your shit up. You're dumb. Yo. Yes. Hey, I like this. Julio, I'll be looking at this in just a minute. Recover recovery instructions. Save and change DNS settings. Reboot hub. Oh shit, that's dead simple. Nice! Okay. Okay, cool. I'm going to be trying that later. Hells yeah, I'd like to view the Metal Gear Zeke development tutorial. Metal Gear, you can develop Metal Gear Zeke, a bipedal tank. Once Metal Gear Zeke is complete, you can deploy this powerful new weapons on outer ops and other missions. Development of Metal Gear Zeke is dependent on parts collected from all the AI weapons you encounter. Parts you can obtain include armaments such as jetpacks and additional armor. These parts vary by AI. This concludes the tutorial. Okay, cool. Customized parts. Main parts. Lock unit? Not equipped. Alright. Okay, so I don't have any... I don't have shit. I can't do anything. What about optional parts? Okay, we've got a jetpack, but we don't have anything to put it on. And I can't paint this fucker until we've got something. And right now he's a useless pile of scrap. Cool. Let's check out our stuff. Got some new dudes. Hells yeah. I came back from space! Is actually what I would yell if I strapped it to my back. How did our dudes do? Team Alpha's returned. Hells yeah, I want to see their results. Select the playback method. Autoplay, I guess. Pew, pew. What the fuck is going on here? Oh, I see, okay. Oh man, that guy's owned. Get wrecked, son. Let's just blow these fuckers up with rocket launchers. That's the way to go. Yeah, no shit, I won. Completely wrecked them. Card with box tank. Rank 1 times 3. Combat ready, love box. Player 1 serves as driver, player 2 as gunner. Press L1 to go into first person view and R1 to fire. Drop to set. Team Bravo has returned. Hells yeah. Autoplay. These guys are gonna get wrecked too. Get wrecked, giant panda. Get wrecked, Goldeneye. Get wrecked, Quail. Man, what's with my dude just using rocket launchers, like anti-tank weapons, against these guys? He'll be pissing blood tomorrow. Parameters went up, yeah! Confidential... Okay, whatever. With camouflage pants. Combat ready love box with a stun cannon. Accepted Otter as a volunteer. Okay, I don't know what that means, but... Destroy this small armored unit. Oh, actually, I suppose I can send my tank out on this too. Yeah. Prepare to get wrecked. Scrubs. Thank you. Actually, let's send this armored vehicle in as well. Okay, I guess that is sufficient. Then we... Oops, that's not what I meant to do. No more water. Attack chopper battle.
Snake, that's a Hind. You've got to take it out somehow. Either neutralize the soldiers or bring down the chopper. Good luck.
Okay, so we determined... Why are you worried about... I mean, it's always a possibility, Useless Rogue, but is there any particular reason you're worried about someone getting swatted? Actually, I'd be really pissed because I just installed a new deadbolt today. Fuck up my doorframe and stuff. Okay, yeah. I don't know. I'm not sure if I just haven't heard as much of it recently, but after there was the incident where that guy got arrested for it, I'm not sure. There might be a bit more repercussions kind of for that kind of thing. I don't know about that, Sadramir. Before the admin bans you, you've gotten some hate mail. Yeah, but the whole swatting thing is completely different from me and all of that. Oh, fuck. Oh, nice, I still got it. Oh man, I just completely... What the fuck is going on? Why was I... Oh, fuck off with your grenades! Fuel tanks under the wings. resistance? I think they are. Yeah. Oh shit, why did I just run into the fucking grenade? God damn it, so I can't get those because... God damn it. Certainly seems like a what would be a successful request to Severmere. Damn it, you dodgy son of a bitch. Oh man, owns. These fights are a little bit questionable, but generally this game is pretty damn good. Look at these noobs. Getting shrecked right off of the... What the fuck is that?
That's gotta be the leader.
Where?
Can you take him down?
Where's the... Ah, that dude. Hang it up. close. There we go.
The leader's down. It's over.
Yeah, rank C. It's obviously a good score. Uniform developed sneaking suit. Sweet!
I got a report in from the R&D team. They finished plans for a new
That is a little bit strange for Cyber America.
Today they're going to start construction on the first block. Can't wait to finally say goodbye to this scrap heap. Only thing is, we don't have nearly enough GMP. We'll need to recruit more soldiers to get more GMP. You know what to do, Snake. Boss, I'm starting to wonder if recruiting the soldiers with a Fulton isn't a little heavy-handed?
I already don't like where this is going.
I think the voluntary approach could be more pragmatic. Technically, we're not a corporate entity, but at our size, that's not too far from the truth. We can't keep using guerrilla tactics to find new blood. To search for volunteers, select recruit from the menu, or select trade to exchange soldiers with other mercenary units.
Yeah, provided we've got the friends for that.
New soldiers will be recruited. We got a FIM, which is an anti-aircraft missile launcher, as far as I'm aware. New plant is being built. Terminating combat operations. Combat operations, okay. Other bases expanded. Recruit functions being added. So what's... Oh shit, what did I just... What? I should have probably read what it said there. Recruit volunteers to MSF. Volunteer recruits are experienced veteran soldiers who will want to evaluate the true strength of the MSF and Snake before they agree to join. Bestman. Oh, okay. Okay, whatever. We're not gonna fuck around with that for right now. I want a goddamn shield. And night vision goggles. Team Bravo has returned. Yep. Let's see how this went. Get wrecked. Oh, he missed. There we go. Get wrecked. Oh, man, stop missing. Yeah, fuck you too, Gan Sam. Also, you spelled it wrong. It's F-R-O-O-T, loops. Cardboard box stun cannon, rank 2 times 3. You idiots! Use the anti-tank weapons against the... that. Oh, we had shotgun ammo. Team Charlie has returned. Stop focusing on Mr. Piranha. Oh god. No! How come that like barely hurt that dude? Transported to sick bay. Transported to sick bay. Okay. All right. Let's go with Team Alpha on this one. Assume that means. Let's go with a few more dudes on this team and send them. Medium combat unit? Okay, well, we'll leave that one. We'll send Bravo on this one. Okay. Did I already do stuff? Yep. Always looking so chill. Hey, Small Fry. I already did R&D, I think. Yeah, I must have. Head to the lab.
Snake, infiltrate Dr. Strangelove's research lab and either deactivate or destroy the AI. The lab's built into some ancient ruins, so find those first.
So we need ID card H. ID card H. Instead of the love box, that's, take a cardboard box tank. Man, what was that snake? Okay. Tiger stripe. You got naked. We got a sneaking suit too, didn't we? Where the hell? Oh, there it is. Nice. Check that out. We're headed for ruins, so I would think maybe the tiger stripe would be a build. Oh shit, actually, that would be a lot better.
Survival. What? Survival. Survival. Stealth. Survival.
Why does he say
stealth. Survival. Survival. Survival.
God, I'm still doing this shit. Yeah. Oh, fuck. Current emission select. I want my hush puppy back.
Snake.
Instead of the law. Wait, I did have the tiger strip or snake on still, yeah. Alright, see you, Weaving Termite. I don't think I'm going to go for too much longer, because I now have a bunch of emails I need to respond to and stuff, so. I was going to say I'll finish this mission, but I don't know how long this mission will take, so. We'll kind of play it by ear.
Scouts are really hard to spot because they use grass or dirt to camouflage themselves. They blend right in with the natural surroundings. Snipers and laser sights are a deadly combination.
Is that a dude up there? I don't know. I wish I could crawl on the floor. Dr. Girlfriend from Venture Bros. Was that Venture Bros? Yeah, that was Venture Bros. Oh shit, look at that dude, being all stealthy like. Also, how the fuck did he not see me?
freeze.
Let's analyze this dude. Holy shit, he's a bee? Look at this dude. He is amazing.
Fulton recovery to helicopter is complete.
The twitching, small fry? Okay, so now I roughly know what those dudes look like when they're all camoed up. Hey, Molar Duck. There's a dude there. Yeah, Molar Duck, the voice of sanity. Okay, who made that noise? Okay, why can't I just, like... Don't tease me, bro. Analyzing time. These dudes are good.
Fulton recovery subject confirmed onboard helicopter.
Oh, it's a prisoner? Is there a guy back in that car? No. Okay, that's interesting. Let's check out his butt. Since that's obviously how you can tell whether they're good or not.
Recovery to helicopter is complete.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Yeah, it's true. Anal probing. It's time tested. Kid tested, mother approved. Anal probing.
Please.
What are you doing here?
Cecile. Cosima. Coming out. You're not
One of the soldiers? Please, lower your gun. Who are you?
I'm an ornithologist.
A poacher?
The gun's for self-defense. I'm looking for that one rare bird in Costa Rica.
Which one? The quetzal?
Right, the quetzal. They're rare, but they're not covered under the Washington Treaty.
The resplendent quetzal is red-listed.
Really?
I like that everyone is... like,
an ornithologist myself.
Ruins his cover. Have to cover, in quotes.
Here, drink some of this.
You saved me. They told me this was a paradise. That there were more rare birds here than anywhere else. That there was no war here. That it was safe. They told me it was every bird's dream. But they were wrong.
What happened?
If only I had not recorded
stupid,
that
stupid,
voice.
Stupid, stupid code. 0001.
Making my way through a thicket, I saw immense runes towering before me.
I chase it away. It will bite you unless you kill it. Go home.
You are the one who made the tape.
I am loyal to myself. Who's there?
Those quotes sounded familiar.
That woman. But she was kind. She gave me food to eat, and even bathed me herself.
Okay.
Each day. But she said I could go home in a month. So whatever you do, don't take off the blindfold. Do so, and you will never leave here.
Guess you didn't listen. How'd you escape?
I waited for an opening. Stole an ID card. They almost caught me. But I managed to elude them.
You made it this far, and then succumbed to exhaustion.
I was barefoot. With no supplies. Oh, I am so sorry.
Except for the stuff that she just shook out onto the ground.
That facility. Did you see anybody else in there?
Well, there was another woman. But I never saw her in person. Because, you know, the blindfold. Oh, yes. She often sang.
Sang?
It was such a strange song.
What kind of person was she? Could you tell anything from her voice?
I don't know. I don't even know why I was held a prisoner. They confiscated my equipment, my supplies, my passport, money, everything. The only thing I was allowed to keep were my undergarments. So that I would not be able to escape. And now, I am without even the means to prove who I am. I will not make it home to Paris like this.
In that case, come to our place.
Huh?
You don't need a passport there. Don't even need a name. If you want to go back to Paris, we'll take you there anytime.
What I want is a shower, a change
of course she wants a cigarette.
I've got a cigar. It's Cuban.
Not French cigarettes? I prefer unfiltered.
Fresh out. But come back to my place. You can have all the French cigarettes you want.
It sounds like heaven.
Close. Not quite. Outer heaven.
It is sounding better all the time.
So, you must have gotten...
Yeah, I was kind of wondering how keeping her undergarments made her not escape, too.
What of machinery? A big computer, like you would see in the university.
What about the room where you heard the voice? Anybody in there?
I don't know. There was a tube. A large tube in the back. When I approached it, I heard a voice.
What did it say?
Jack. Yes, it simply said Jack, over and over.
Jack.
Listen, you've got to get me out of here. I really need a shower.
Wait here. I still got business to take care of.
What? You're not thinking of going in there, are you? You can't leave me here.
Relax. I'll have some friends pick you up.
Yeah, I mean, they're in Costa Rica. I don't think keeping warm is too much of an issue.
Civilian.
Snake, we don't have room for any more civilians here.
Not even for a blonde Parisienne.
A what? So she's pretty foxy?
See for yourself. If what she's saying is true, I think we've found Paz's friend.
The missing one?
I'm thinking that she's the one that made that tape. Have her listen to it when she gets there.
Ryden is Jack, but Jack was also a
good news
code
I'm
name.
Sure Paz will be glad to
or
hear
a real name of
you bet.
Of
Snake.
Naked Snake.
The ruins are just up ahead. Head north.
On my way.
What about me?
Filled it up with one of those level E guys. Yeah.
I wonder what it's like to be a bird.
Huh?
Actually, I don't want that cigar. Eat taser, fucker. Oh fuck, I missed. There we go. He's dead. Sweet. Got some Doritos. Oh, perfect timing. Okay, does that dude turn around there? He better fucking turn around.
What's that?
It's nothing, dude.
Guess not.
I don't think you can Fulton them without knocking them out. Oh, fuck. Good thing you can't see me. I'm totally not suspicious here at all. Nothing here.
Guess not.
Guess not.
What? Is someone there?
Nope. Eat a dick! So check this thing out. Impressed with my covertness. The part where I was actually covert, or the part where I told them to eat dick and shot them to death. It does shoot. I don't want to shoot it because I'm not sure if it's single shot. And you can put two people in it, so you can have a gunner and a... not gunner.
What? It won't open. Damn.
It won't open? What's wrong with it?
Yeah, you can have a gunner and a driver. Useless rogue. Wait, which big stream were you talking about? Where with Small Fry? The don't starve. Giant googly eyes on the tank.
Huey, your ID card isn't working.
All right, later, Blue Bomber.
You open the lock.
I think I'm gonna stop now.
It can't be.
What's going on?
She hates me that much?
Strangelove's in charge of authorizing IDs. Sometimes a working card has its privileges removed. Say, if she decides she doesn't like that card's carrier.
You think that's what happened?
Well, I was never exactly her favorite. Well, this could be tricky. The soldiers outside aren't allowed in the lab either, so their cards won't do you any good.
Great.
Snake.
Kaz, where's Cecile?
She just got here. Hold on.
Snake!
Cecile, how'd it feel to fly?
Wonderful. For a moment, I felt what it must be like to be a bird. It almost made me want to give up my research and get a pilot's license. Did you need something?
You said you'd gotten an ID card, right?
Yes, but it was confiscated when the guards got me.
Who took it? What did he look like?
He had an arms jacket. I cannot recall his face, though.
Yeah, they all look pretty much the same. Where did it happen?
Let me think. Ah, yes! I do remember hearing the song of a nearby quetzal.
Just what I'd expect from a birder.
Would you like to hear it?
Huh? What's that song?
It's my quetzal. I took it with me when I was rescued.
Didn't you say something about them being covered under the Washington Convention?
Just kidding. That was just me. An imitation. An essential skill for any ornithologist. Pretty good, no?
Damn good.
I have put a few guys in horizontal pooping position, but I don't think you can drag them around, so I'm not sure.
All about the birds of Costa Rica, too.
Yeah, will do. Thanks, Cecile.
No. Thank you, Snake. Talk to you soon.
Kaz, did you play that tape for Cecile?
I sure did. It's hers, all right.
Then she must be.
She's not. Cecile says she's never even met Paz.
What?
She's at least 10 years too old.
But...
I'm guessing Paz convinced herself that it was the tape her friend made. But never mind that. Let's go over what we know so far. The soldier with the ID card is wearing an orange jacket and is in a location where you'll hear Quetzal singing. Find that soldier, retrieve that card.
Saved successfully. Alright, so just like last time, we'll do the mother base stuff and then I'm gonna stop. these guys. Dicks. Check out our other ops. Yeah, I'm just gonna go through all the mother base stuff and save, and then we'll be done. Oh jeez, this is rough. You've never seen IT Crowd use this rogue? You need to watch that shit right away. God, these guys are the worst. What? How are there this many people who have not seen it? See their shit. Autoplay. Let's watch them wreck these guys. So these are the outer ops. So essentially, you can send your guys out on missions. This is a PowerPoint, yeah. Yeah, chocolate chip outfit. Box bomb. Oh my god! Awesome. These guys are just gonna get straight up shreked. Oh, wow. Or maybe I'm gonna get straight up shreked. What's going on? Maybe all my guys are just gonna pull out their rocket launchers. Hey, Somnambulist, you're here just in time for the end of the stream. Send anyone else out on a mission for now. Let's look at our stuff. Got a whole bunch of people in the waiting room. Auto-assign those fuckers. Ooh, Fulton rank 3. Got a whole bunch of dudes in sickbay now. Okay, R&D. Weapons. Oh, actually, I more want the upgraded Fulton than anything else. Okay, so we will save up and I'll stop for now. So we'll stop for now and maybe I'll... Oh no, I guess tomorrow's a chill stream from Ryan. So yeah, tomorrow's a chill stream, so I probably won't be streaming tomorrow. And Tuesday? Maybe Tuesday. I guess Tuesday's probably the next day I'll be streaming. Alright.